Hey guys, here's the whole topic summary for AQA physics, magnetism and electromagnets. This has some of the coolest practicals in it. If you want to make sure that you've covered all of the practicals, you can get a knowledge checklist over in my free revision guide, or you can get that from Amazon.
When we have two like poles, they're going to repel. But when we have two unlike poles, they're going to attract. A permanent magnet is going to have a magnetic field which goes from north to south. And we can induce a magnet, a temporary magnet, if we place something inside that magnetic field. Magnetic materials are going to be metals, and that is going to include iron, nickel, and cobalt. You can easily make an electromagnet at home. All you need is a battery, some wire, and an iron nail. Because all an electromagnet is an iron core with a wire around it connected up to a current. You can use this to pick up things like paper clips or iron filings. When a current is passed through the wire, it creates a magnetic field around the wire, and this in turn strongly magnetises the iron bar, thus creating our electromagnet. If you want to change the strength of an electromagnet, you can do two things. You can change the current, or you can change the number of turns or the number of coils that the wire, times the wire is wrapped around the iron core. For Fleming's left-hand rule, we need to make our left hand in this shape here. So finger pointing out, thumb up, finger out. And your first finger is your magnetic field. This finger here is the current, and then your thumb is the movement of the force. And what you need to do when you have an exam question is literally you can contort your hand until it fits in the right direction. So first was nice and easy. My field is going in that direction. My current is going in that direction. So the movement of the force is going upwards. This one here is a bit more complicated because this finger needs to be pointing in that direction. My current needs to be going down, and then my thumb is going into the page. We can change the size of the force by changing the current. By changing the strength of the magnet. Or by changing the angle between the wire and the magnetic field lines. The greatest force is when the wire is perpendicular with magnetic field lines, and the force is going to be zero if the wire and the field lines are parallel. Magnetic flux density is the amount of magnetic flux in a certain area, and the equation that we use for this is force equals magnetic flux density times current times length. You'll notice, really annoyingly, that this is an uppercase I and a lowercase L. Our units for this, for force, are newtons. For magnetic flux density, they are tesla. For current, it is amps. And for length, that is meters. While this is called a simple electric motor, there's actually quite a lot of physics going on here. And for this, we really need to use our Fleming's left-hand rule. So our magnetic field is going from north to south like this.
our current is moving actually in two different directions. On this side, it's moving in this direction, and on the other side, it's moving in this direction. So what we are going to have is that when the wire is moving past the south bit of the magnet, the force is going to be going down, and when it's moving past the north face of the magnet, the force is going to be going up. And because one side is being pushed down, the other side is being pushed up, it is going to turn around. A moving coil loudspeaker works by making a diaphragm attached to a coil vibrate. When we have a current passing through the coil, the force that is generated via the motor effect makes the coil move. Every time the current changes direction, the force reverses direction. So the coil is going to be going back and forwards, making the diaphragm go back and forward, generating sound waves. A moving coil microphone works with the same principle but in the opposite direction. Sound causes the diaphragm to vibrate, the diaphragm is attached to the coil. The vibration of the diaphragm moves the coil, which is going to cause the coil to move backwards and forwards past the magnet. The generator effect is just an extension of Fleming's left-hand rule. When we have a wire and we move it through a magnetic field, we are going to be generating a current. In a transformer, we have a soft iron core. We have a wire which is going to be coiling around, and you notice there are a different number of coils here. We are going to be looking at varying the number of coils so that we can vary the voltage that goes into and comes out of our transformer. If we have a step-up transformer, the secondary voltage is going to be greater than the primary voltage, so the voltage coming out is going to be greater than the voltage going in. If we have a step-down transformer, the secondary voltage is going to be less than the primary voltage, so the voltage coming out is going to be less than the voltage going in. When we are looking at transformers calculations, we have voltage in the primary coil divided by voltage in the secondary coil equals the number of turns in the primary coil divided by the number of turns in the secondary coil. Our units for this are going to be for voltage, that is volts, and number of turns doesn't have a unit because it's just a number. You need to know that voltage in the secondary coil times the current in the secondary coil is equal to voltage in the primary coil times the current in the primary coil. And our units for voltage are volts for current, amps, voltage, volts, currents, amps.